In the picture over here, we see Bob the Builder. Now, Bob is a very experienced carpenter, and a person in his town came to him with a certain problem. The problem was that that person wanted a wooden table in the shape of a trapezium. Now, it was to be exactly in the shape of a trapezium, as you can see. Now, Bob wondered how much wood would Bob need in order to construct this particular table. So, in order to know how much wood he needs, he would have to know what is the area of a trapezium. Now, Bob was a highly skilled carpenter. So, now let us see how Bob used his knowledge in order to construct a trapezium table. So, in order to construct the trapezium table, Bob would have to know the area of the trapezium. Now, there is a very simple activity by which we can find out the area of this trapezium. Firstly, we consider the trapezium. As you can see, it has a pair of parallel sides which are known as the bases, marked out as B1 and B2. And the non-parallel sides of the legs are A and C. The height of the trapezium has also been denoted. That is the length in between, or the distance in between, the two parallel sides. Now, in order to calculate its area, the activity we perform is, we copy this trapezium exactly as it is. So, we get a similar trapezium that is exactly the same. Now, what we do is, we take this particular trapezium and we invert it. Or in other words, we turn it upside down. So, over here, as you can see, I have turned the trapezium upside down. And now I take this trapezium and I place it beside the original trapezium. So, as you can see, I have placed this inverted trapezium beside the original trapezium. Now, if you look closely, B2 has now come to the bottom and B1 has gone to the top for the inverted trapezium. Now, can you tell me what this looks like? If you find closely and look closely, you will see that this side A is the same as this side A. And as you can see, they are parallel to one another. And also, this side is parallel to this side. And these sides are parallel. So, what does this indicate? This indicates that the figure which we obtained is a parallelogram. Now, how can we find out the area of a parallelogram? We had studied earlier that the area of a parallelogram is nothing but base into height. So, over here, the base of the parallelogram is B1 plus B2. And the height is the height of the trapezium, that is h in this case. Now, if you observe closely, you will find that the parallelogram which we are considering is made up of two such trapezium. That is the initial trapezium which we had considered. So, obviously, if the parallelogram is made up of two same trapezium, we can say that the area of the trapezium is half the area of the parallelogram. So, I will write now that area of the trapezium will be half the area of the parallelogram, or in other words, it will be half into B1 plus B2 into H. Thus, the area of the trapezium is half into sum of the bases into its height. So, this is how we can calculate the area of any given trapezium. And this is the exact amount of wood that Bob would need in order to construct his trapezium-shaped table. Now, let us consider a slight problem. Mr. Verma over here has to renovate his house, and in order to do that, he has to paint his trapezium-shaped wall. Now, this wall, as you see, is trapezium in shape, and the sides of it are as given. The bases of the trapezium are 7 meters and 10 meters. The height of the trapezium is 4 meters and this side is 5 meter. So these two sides are the bases and these two sides are the legs. And it has also been given to us that one of the legs is perpendicular. So this also gives us the height. Now Mr. Verma not only has to paint the entire wall, he also has to apply a tape around the wall. So in order to apply the tape, he will have to know the perimeter of the trapezium. So the perimeter of the trapezium is nothing but the sum of all the four sides. That is 4 plus 7 plus 5 plus 10. 4 plus 7 is 11, plus 5, 16, plus 10, 26. So 26 meters is the perimeter of the trapezium. And this is the amount of tape that he would need. Further, in order to paint the wall, Mr. Verma would have to know the area of the wall. So the area of the trapezium can be found out very easily from the formula which we previously obtained. That is, half into the sum of bases. That is 10 plus 7. Multiplied by the height, which in this case is 4. So this formula will give us the area of the trapezium. Now over here, I cancelled the denominator 2 because there is a common factor. And what do I get? 10 plus 7, 17 into 2. 34 meter square. So 34 meter square is the area of the trapezium. And this is the amount of paint that Mr. Verma would need in order to paint his trapezium shaped wall. Now in the previous example, we saw that the height had been given and so we could easily calculate the area of the trapezium. Now consider a scenario where the height hasn't been given. What has been given is only the two bases and the two legs. Now in this case, we consider another problem. Over here, as you can see, this particular window is in the shape of an isosceles trapezium. And this has been given to us. The bases are B2 and B1 and the legs are of sides A. However, we do not know the height. Now the problem is that there was a break in the window. And in order to rectify this, the engineer had been called in and he had to find out the area of the entire window to know how much glass he needs. Now in order to know how much glass he needs, he has to find out the area. So in this case also, the area of an isosceles trapezium will be equal to the area of any trapezium. That is, we can apply the same formula. But the problem is that we do not have the height that is essential to calculate the area. So what do we do? From this figure itself, we can easily calculate the height. Now firstly, I will write the formula. That is half into B1 plus B2 into H. So this is the formula for area of a trapezium. Now what I need to find out is the value of H. Now if you notice closely, you will see that we are dropping a perpendicular from this vertex onto the base B1. Now in a similar manner, if I drop another perpendicular on base B1, it will fall over here. Now I can say that since I have dropped two perpendiculars, I am getting a rectangle. And we know that in a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. So this side is also equal to B2. Now what we are left with is this side and this side. So the sum of these sides would be B1 minus this length, which is B2. And if you notice closely, you will know that this side is equal to this side because we have considered an isosceles trapezium and we are dropping a perpendicular from both the vertices over here onto base B1. So we can say that this particular length is B1 minus B2 divided by 2. Now consider this triangle. Consider this triangle. In that particular triangle, you can see it is a right angle triangle, and we have been given the hypotenuse A, the base, which is this, and height h, and we have to calculate this height h. So what can we say? We can say that h square, that is the right angle, plus the base, that is b1 minus b2 divided by 2 whole square, is equal to a square, which is the hypotenuse. So I write h square plus b1 minus b2 divided by 2 whole square equals a square. Now if I simply rearrange this equation, I will easily obtain the value of h. So I write h as root over, I take this value to the other side, and I obtain a square minus b1 minus b2 divided by 2 whole square. So this is the formula for h. Now things might seem a bit tricky and difficult at first, but let us solve a problem in order to ease things out. We will solve the problem by applying this formula for height when height has not been given. Now the problem that we consider is, it is a weekend in PVR cinemas, and owing to the fact that it is a weekend, there is a huge rush of men and women. So obviously there is a huge crowd, and the manager is facing an acute shortage of popcorn boxes. Now he has ordered his workers to make more and more popcorn boxes, but the workers have no idea about the shape. All they know is that it is supposed to look like this, and the measures have been given, but they do not know how much material they need in order to make these popcorn boxes. So why don't we help the workers? Now as you can see, it has been given to us that the popcorn boxes are in the shape of an isosceles trapezium. So in order to know how much material is needed, we simply need to find out the area of the isosceles trapezium. As you can see, the height of the isosceles trapezium has not been given to us. What has been given to us are only the bases and this particular leg. Now, since this is an isosceles trapezium, both the legs will be equal. So using the previous formula that we had obtained, let us try to find out the height. Now the formula for height was h root over a square, that is this, minus b1 minus b2 by 2 whole square. Over here, 16 is b1 and 6 is b2. So I have replaced the values. A is 13, b1 is 16, and b2 is 6. So I have considered 13 square minus half of 16 minus 6 whole square. Now I need to simplify this. I write 13 square, and let's see how I can simplify this term. Over here, 16 minus 6 will give me 10, so I get half of 10. Or in other words, 1 by 2 into 10, which is nothing but 5, and the square of 5. So I get 13 square minus 5 square. Now 13 square is 169, 5 square is 25. So this evaluates to root over 144, which is nothing but 144 centimeters square. This is equal to 12 square centimeters square, because 12 into 12 is equal to 144. Thus, I get the value of height, that is h, as 12 centimeters. Now I have obtained the value of h, and I know the values of B1, which is equal to 16 centimeters, and B2, which is equal to 6 centimeters, and I also know the height. So I can easily calculate the area. The area will be nothing but half into B1 plus B2 into H. So I replace the values, half into B1, that is 16, plus B2, that is 6, into H, which we obtained as 12. So from this formula, we can now easily calculate the area. I cancel out 2 as it has a common factor, and I get 6. So 16 plus 6 is equal to 22, and 22 into 6 is equal to 132 centimeter square. So 132 centimeter square is the area of the face of the popcorn box, and this is the amount of material that the workers would need. Thus, we have helped solve the movie theater crisis, and very efficiently, by using this particular formula. Obviously, as you see, after solving this problem, this formula does not seem that difficult.